Hello, 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 everybody. My name is Steve Ford, and welcome to your English lesson. Today, we have a great lesson talking about words that sound the same but are spelt differently. And I hope that I can help you understand these words better. So, are you ready? Let's go. Do you have a family heirloom? Heirloom. So, probably even for advanced students, this is a new word. An heirloom, as you can see in the description here, is an object which has been in the family for generations. So here we have perhaps jewelry or a ring, right? A necklace, perhaps a purse, maybe this compass here or an old camera or maybe just photos. Yes, this is a family heirloom. This is an object that stays in the family for generations, from grandmother to daughter to granddaughter, or grandfather to grandfather to son to grandson. And maybe you have jewelry from your grandparents or your great-great-grandparents. Maybe you have an old watch or clock you got from your... And we have A, and then we have A. So in this case, we would say maybe you got it from someone in your family. And if we say that, it would be from your aunt. But just so that you know, aunt, the sister of your mother, an ant, that little insect, is the same pronunciation in American English. Now, from my experience, a lot of my students who learn British English will say aunt. Totally normal. I get that all the time. In American English, these two words are pronounced the same way. Aunt and ant. There's no difference? No difference. It's the same pronunciation. Aunt and ant. Now, in the house where I grew up, this is a true story, actually. And I like true stories. I think that they're much more meaningful. We had an antique clock. Yes, we did. And I can remember you could hear the tick-tock of the clock, and the bell struck every hour. And it struck like this. So, true story. We had a clock. Maybe your family has an old clock similar to that. It was a family heirloom. These old clocks did not have batteries, so you had to wind the clock. Wind. W-I-N-D. You can wind many things. You can wind toys. You can wind animals. You can wind people. I was running along the beach yesterday. There was a lot of wind. Woo! Lots of wind. Look at that poor cat holding on because there's so much wind. So here we have two words that are spelled the same way, but their pronunciation is different. So the word wind, noun, and wind, verb, are spelled the same, but when pronounced differently, have a different meaning. Wind and wind. And these two words, that is to say, these two meanings used in different contexts. Well, how do you know? You're going to ask me, how do you know when to use the different pronunciation? And it really depends on the context. So back to the beach. During my run, I stopped to take a picture and I decided to give a big wave to the camera. You can see wave, but my camera got wet because of a big wave. Okay. In these two cases, we have the same pronunciation and the same spelling, but they mean two different things. So this is a little different. So we have wave, and we have wave, a big wave. So I can give a big wave and then I can show you a picture of the big wave. Now, at the beach, there were some people taking advantage of the windy weather. I don't know whether it was more dangerous to be kite surfing. And this was true. So when I went running yesterday, there were these people kite surfing. And it was crazy because it was super cold and super windy. There was a lot of wind and it was really cold. And I'm running. I can't really see in front of me. And then in the ocean, I see these people and they are kite surfing. And you can see that we have weather, windy weather, and then weather in terms of if. And those two words are pronounced the same way. This is, of course, pronunciation, no difference. Sail, like sailboat, and then go to a store and buy something on sale. The beach where I run also has a dog beach. And this is true. These are things that you only see in Vancouver, probably. I don't think I ever saw this when I was living in Toronto or when I visited Montreal. I never saw this when I was in Brazil. Never saw this when I was in France. This is something very Vancouver. So the beach where I run also has a dog beach. And by the way, a female dog is known technically as a bitch, not the same sound. And one of my students, a Brazilian student, she, wonderful person, she asked me, Steve, I really have problems with the word beach and bitch. And a lot of people do. In case you didn't know, bitch originally comes from female dog, and the sound is different. Very short. And you smile when you say beach. So maybe that bitch at the is smiling. I don't know. So be careful there. It's not the same sound. There was a small dog and a big dog racing. The small one won. So yet again, we have two words that have exactly the same pronunciation, they're spelled differently. The small one won. And I would like to say, especially be careful with this one because I have heard some non-native English speakers when they try to pronounce this first one here, this one, sometimes they'll say un instead of one. So it doesn't matter. Both words, they have a w sound, a w sound at the beginning. So, you know, at the beginning of a story, maybe in Game of Thrones, the very first one, they would say, once upon a time. Yeah, once. Once again, w. You want to get that w sound. So we say one. So these two dogs were racing. And it's always funny because when I'm running on the dog beach and you think, oh, there's a big dog. There's a big one, and then there's a small dog, there's a small one. And you think, okay, well, the big dog, if they're racing, if they're running at the same time, of course the big dog is going to be the champion, right? Like he is the champion. Not necessarily. Sometimes the small dog, I don't know how, is like, blah, blah, blah. You know, like they can run faster than the big dog. Maybe. Okay, everybody, this was a short lesson. I am going to explain a few more words that sometimes are spelled differently but are pronounced the same. If you would like to subscribe to my channel, you can do that at the end of this video. I will show a link also below this video. You can join me on Facebook, Instagram, or WhatsApp with English with Steve. Hope that you enjoyed this short lesson on pronunciation, everybody. It's kind of a continuation from a lesson I did 2 weeks ago talking about homophones. And today we talked about both homophones and homographs, as you could see in my examples. I will try to post some pronunciation quizzes for these videos that I have been doing. If you would like to watch many pronunciation videos, I have 60 lessons for pronunciation, and I will post a link. If you come back and watch a recording of this lesson, the link will be here. And you can, if you're not subscribed to my channel already, you can subscribe here. And I hope to see you next time on YouTube Live. That's going to be next Sunday at 2:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I really hope that you enjoy the lesson. Bye, everybody.